Welcome to Chatterbox Quilts. I'm Kim. In this episode, I'm going to be showing you another variation on the snowball block. Now, I have shown you a variation before on this one, and I've shown you some other quick quilt blocks, and if you haven't seen those episodes, you can look in the description below because I put a link to a playlist I've created that has all those quick quilt block episodes in it, so you'll find them all in one place. So if you haven't looked at those yet and you want to, look in the description below for that particular link to the playlist. So what this one is looking like today is like a diamond. Now keep in mind that we haven't stitched this into a quilt yet, so when you do that you're going to be taking up a quarter of an inch in here, so it's going to blunt those edges a little bit. So that's what it looks like unfinished. How do you create this block? Well, you need a background block, of course. So today I'm using a 6-inch block, and you need four squares that are going to be the corner squares, and these are actually 3 inches. So that they're going to actually kind of just about meet when you stitch them together. What you need to do is you need to take your squares that are going to be the corner squares, and you need to draw a diagonal line from corner to corner on each of those squares. So I've done the other three, and I'll just show you how I do it with this particular one. Make sure you use removable marker because you don't want this to show through on light fabrics. I'm using a friction pen to do this. So we just go along there. And you're going to mark all your other corners, or squares I should say, the same way. I want to call them corners because that's what they're going to end up being eventually. Now you want to make sure that when we stitch these out on the machine, which I'm going to do next, that they all are oriented the right way. So you want them to look like that diamond shape. You want them to be oriented so they look like what the finished block is going to look like this. Okay, so you don't want to have them going the wrong way. You don't want to have some like this and some like this. That is not going to work out at all. Okay, make sure they're this way. The next thing you're going to need to do is go to the sewing machine, and we're going to stitch on the diagonal lines. But there's some important information I want to tell you about when we get the sewing machine to make sure this block is going to come out correctly. So the next thing we're going to do is go to the sewing machine, and I'll give you that tip before we start sewing. I brought my blocks over to the sewing machine. I'm ready to put them on. I just wanted to explain a little further about how you should be stitching these on. In other words, the order you stitch them on. So you could stitch on this block and that block, and that would be fine. You could not stitch on this block and this block right one after the other without pressing them out. And the reason you can't do that is because you will end up like this, because they overlap a little bit. So you're gonna end up with something like this. Won't be quite that drastic, but it's still going to work the same way. You're not going to be able to press them out. So you don't want to do that. So to avoid that, you could stitch these two on first, and then you want to press them out, and then do the other two blocks. So next step is to actually stitch these on the corner. So I'm just going to line it up right sides together with the corner, making sure that when you finish stitching and you flip, it's going out towards the corner. So I'm just going to do that now. I'm using an open toe applique foot just for demonstration purposes. I would suggest that you use your regular presser foot for this, but just so you can see what I'm doing easier, I'm using this particular foot. Okay, so I would stitch the other corner, or other block I should say, on the opposite corner here, and then I would press them both out before I continue any further. The other thing I would like to do on these particular ones is I can get a bonus half square triangle off each of these corners because they're a good size, and to do that I'm just going to stitch a quarter inch away from the stitched line already. Okay, so this is about a quarter inch away, and I'm just going to use the inside of my applique pressing foot to go along that stitching line. Okay, so opposite corner going to get stitched on, and then we're going to press both those open, and then we're going to do the opposite one. So I'm going to do that now, and then I'll meet you back at the pressing area and show you how we're going to trim these up. And I'm going to be at the cutting area as well, I guess, because that's really what I need is the cutting area, not the pressing area. Okay, so I'm going to finish these. I'll meet you back there. So I've got this all stitched up, and now I'm ready to trim it up and get those bonus half square triangles. So let's do that. So remember, we're just going to trim in between those two stitching lines, trying to get sort of even. The main thing is not to trim across a stitching line. That's really what you want to make sure you don't do. And I must admit, every time I trim these corners up, I kind of have that feeling of shock all of a sudden where I kind of go, wait a minute, am I cutting in the wrong place? So if you're like me and you sometimes wonder if you're cutting in the right place, just look twice before you actually cut, because you know, you can take out stitching and that'll work just fine. You can't undo cutting, I'm afraid to say. And there's nothing worse than cutting something that you shouldn't have and you have to start all over again. Nobody likes that feeling. So just take a couple minutes, make sure you've got your ruler in the right place between those two stitching lines before you cut. Okay, so there's our block. He's all trimmed up. I now have four bonus half square triangles. Okay, so you can see what those look like. I must say when they get small like this, they're hard to open sometimes. So you can just open them and I press to the dark side and that'll give me four little half square triangles that I can add to another project. So I can press those out or leave them like this if I want, it doesn't really matter. But the one thing I wanted to show you is what you can do with these kinds of stitch and flip blocks, especially this particular one. It makes a really nice frame if you have some fabric where you want to highlight a motif. So you can fussy cut your background block with the motif you want to see kind of more in the center. Okay, so you kind of have to play around a little bit with it. But then you can get something like this. So it shows you the nice little motif on this particular fabric. And this isn't a cotton, this isn't, I don't know what. This is some kind of a, I think a polyester or something. I don't think it's silk. But anyway, it's very pretty, I thought, and it looks really nice like that. And if you want to make it really easy on yourself and you want to make a wall hang, you've got a big motif, blow this up, make it big, make it 20 inches square for your background block or 18 inches square. Throw a couple borders on maybe, and you've got yourself maybe a 24 inch or 26 inch wall hang. So that makes it really easy. Or if you want to make these blocks, you know, 20 inches, you'd only have to put a few together to give you a lap size quilt. So keep that in mind, because this is a really nice block to do that and feature those motifs on fabrics that you really hate to cut up because they got those nice big motifs in them. Make a snowball block with them and make a wall hang, make a lap quilt, keep going, make a queen size bed quilt if you want. Anyway, those are just some ideas for what you can do with that particular variation of a snowball block. I also wanted to let you know that I have a private Facebook group. It's called Chatterbox Quilts, and I've put a link in the description below. I'd love to have you join me over there. That is where I spend a lot of my time chatting with like-minded quilters who talk about quilting, of course, vintage sewing machines, all kinds of things, books, fabric, whatever we're working on or why we're not working on something. So I'd love to have you join me over there for those discussions. Again, look in the description for the link.